I can make a motion if it's appropriate.
Please feel free.
Okay. I move that the commission approve the inspection and maintenance program submitted by Southern California Edison in accordance with Special Condition 7 of CDP 9150228, and I'm recommending a yes vote.
Second.
Thank you. It was moved by Bochco, seconded by Uranga. Would either of you like to speak further to the motion, Commissioner Bochco?
But just very briefly, I think staff has done an incredibly good job on this, and it's never easy to really approve of this kind of a situation, but we always find ourselves in a position that it's the only recourse at the moment. And so I think we're all trying to push as hard as possible to encourage the federal government to step up and do what they should have done 40 or 50 years ago. Thank you.
So, Commissioner Uranga?
Commissioner Bochco said it all. That's exactly my concern, is that we need to get cracking on getting a permanent location for these canisters. And once we get that, then this will be resolved. So happy to move it forward because we need to move on. Thank you.
I agree. And okay, I'm going to weigh in. I think that first on the outset, I want to say that in terms of the basic instincts and the outrage and the aversion to the idea of storing commercial spent nuclear materials in the coastal zone should be, you know, preposterous and outrageous to all of us. It should be something that should never either circumstantially or legally ever been allowed to occur. It is an utter failure on the part of not just this federal government, but to be frankly, many governments before that, going back many years, and all of us collectively, frankly, as a society, in failing to grapple with this fundamental question that while on the one hand, at one point in our history, nuclear energy was touted as statistically safe, which it was, and cleaner than other means of production of energy, relatively speaking, all statistically true, but we don't need to look any farther than Fukushima or Chernobyl or Three Mile Island or other cases where in that rare possibility, even when it's not probable, when things go bad, they go really, really bad. And in today's world, in the 21st century, we know that we can invest in renewable energy sources that don't include nuclear, and we can create a secure green energy economy in the future that is a lot more sane. And so first, not just as a chair of this commission, but also as the commissioner that represents this area where Songs is located, I can tell you I'm as outraged as anyone else that this even, we're in a situation, I think as Commissioner Bochco said very clearly, is untenable. And we continue to do our best to push on those things that we do have some jurisdiction over. All of that, and I think I just keep reiterating that the community activism, the great leadership we've seen from our local representatives in Congress, particularly Congressman Levin and others, to push this agenda that this issue needs to be solved, and the utter failure that we don't have a national strategic plan with any funding to put permanent repository for spent nuclear materials and get the heck out of that business is beyond me. But I think the voices are growing louder and the activism should continue on that question. And I would go so far as to say that you could probably include most of this commission in the roster of people willing to add our voices to that effort. That said, I think that our agency and our staff have the right strategy here, which is sadly not having great faith in our federal government to accomplish that anytime soon. The idea being the sooner the decommissioning moves forward at this location, the sooner other areas of the site open up for possible relocation, even on site, that may be superior to being as further landward than what we're looking at here. So then comes the question before us today, which is whether or not Condition 7 of the 2015 permit approving that IFSPC, that this plan that's been brought forward is adequate to meet that condition. And that's what's before us today. And what is the evidence in the record? And we have testimony, of course, from the applicant, but we also have substantial testimony from LPI, an independent reviewer that we selected and managed as an agency, and made sure that they were independent and they're experts, that with respect to the 2035 expiration time, the annual reporting, the materials, means, and methods of inspection, all the conversation we had about contingency and what's necessary, all of that, I think is pretty substantial, at least on that question, that at least in the short term, this plan is probably adequate to and complies with our condition 7 of the 2015 permit. So for those reasons, I will support adopting the plan, but I really do think that we need to continue to be a major voice and presence in the broader conversation about identifying permanent offsite repository for this type of material as no business being in the coastal zone of California. And it's frustrating to me that we have zero jurisdiction or control over the actual materials or the movement of those materials. That's the federal government, and we need to keep pushing. So with that said, I'll support the motion. It is a no win, I think, for all of us, but I think under the circumstances, the right step. So that's my two cents. Are there any other commissioners that want to speak to the motion or the second? Commissioner Amenzader?
Yes, just very briefly, Chair Padilla. You know, Chair Padilla said that the IMP is probably adequate. That's not the standard that I think we all want to meet typically when we approve a permit. I think we look for a much higher standard, particularly when nuclear waste is at issue. I do see outstanding gaps in the IMP, but I will be supporting the motion because I'm not in a position to second guess staff as to exactly how. I think I have a similar take as Chair Padilla of it perhaps is adequate. There's certainly testimony that gives me pause, but I am not in a position to direct otherwise as Allison suggested. I would ask though too, you know, that we find a way, whether it's a flowchart or a frequently asked questions document, to be a more proactive center for communicating with the public about this, because it feels very insufficient. We have a very narrow scope today and in general on this project, but we need to find a way, I think, to be a productive channel for the very justified fear and protest of the public on this project. And despite the fact that we have sort of a narrow regulatory box. So I take that challenge to myself. I put that challenge to my fellow commissioners and to staff to find a way to engage more broadly in this process, whether or not that's, you know, outside of our decisions, and finding a way to connect the public with the right piece of the process to make an impact. But yeah, that's all I'll say. Thank you.
Thanks, Commissioner. And I agree with you wholeheartedly. And I think Commissioner Amenzada's suggestion that we really can do more as an agency to be a point in which we can be a clearinghouse for clear, understandable information for the public about this issue, particularly around the process here, is a really a wise suggestion, and we should follow it. So let's take that to heart. Maybe we can, Ms. Detmer, in the future follow up, we can report out some specific actions we're going to take as an agency to be able to help facilitate that. Are there other commissioners that would like to address the motion and the second? I see none. Then we'll call the question and ask for a roll call vote. Mover and seconder asking for a yes vote. Ms. Miller?
Commissioner Amenzada?
Yes.
Amenzada, yes. Commissioner Bochco?
Yes.
Bochco, yes. Commissioner Brownsey?
Aye.
Brownsey, yes. Commissioner Groom?
Yes.
Groom, yes. Commissioner Hart?
Yes.
Hart, yes. Commissioner Howell?
Aye.
Howell, yes. Commissioner Rice?
Yes.
Rice, yes. Commissioner Uranga?
Aye.
Uranga, yes. Commissioner Wilson?
Boo, yes.
Wilson, yes. Chair Padilla?
You know, I've never heard that one before, Wilson. I actually, you know, a boo yes. You know, I think the chair will echo that and register my boo yes. Wow, that's a new one.
The vote is unanimous.
Thank you. With that, the compliance conditions are validated and approved. The program is approved. Thank you, everyone, for your patience and for everyone's participation.